some reason, when my turns back, my headphones. Sure. Yeah, I'm starting in the close-up mode because the game did not transfer the sound to my headphone. But now it should have worked, so let's switch over to... There we go. Should be coming 10 minutes. Alright, so we're back at LA Noire. I believe it's the second case on the traffic desk. It's the first case, now we're on to the second one. Snack on time. Trail mix a lot. It's great. Try raisin. The council's car. Just flash.
Okay, we're gonna keep this short. I'm already late for the DA. First up, Phelps, Bukowski. We got a report of a brand new Packard abandoned in an empty lot off 2nd Street between Olive and Grand. PR is one Oswald Jacobs says the vehicle was dumped in his backyard. There's a patrolman on site. Get down there and see what you can turn up. Any questions? Good. Get going.
Yeah, I'm moving up to a 45. I want to put him down in one way.
Better go earn our pathetic wages.
Rimsky, O'Halloran. Intelligence has information on a stolen car racket.
An abandoned vehicle. You catch all the good ones, huh, Phelps?
Sounds like there's more to it than that. Nobody dumps a shiny new Packard unless they borrowed it without asking.
You don't say. You're on fire today, Einstein.
Very funny.
Come on, my protege. Let's go save the world.
This is our car. We don't ride in the big police cars anymore.
You can drive.
You hear about Adrian? Brought in Seattle, threw him out. Wife says she's gonna take
Adrian!
Her back.
Women generally show more compassion.
What are you talking about? Adrian dumped on her. He was humping the secretary. Margaret should show some pride.
Pride comes before a fall, Bukowski. Talking from experience.
So last stream, there was like a little snippet in the intro that got muted because it was copyright. Hopefully there's no more of that, especially with this music that's playing overhead.
Phelps, traffic.
I'm Officer Houlihan. Car's down the alleyway, detectives.
Yeah.
We got a call about an abandoned vehicle?
Yes, sir. The car has flags. Might be some kind of diplomatic vehicle.
Has anyone touched this vehicle since you arrived?
No. And that Jacobs bird over there was on station before I got here.
We'll talk with him in a moment. Give us some time to look the place over.
Sure, take your time. He's a sore-headed old son of a bitch anyway.
All right, let's look at this car. Start, go from A and go down from there. Like the window was broken in. Packard Clipper.
The Argentinian Embassy.
Consulate General of Argentina, Suite 210, 5055 Wilshire Boulevard, Los Angeles. L. Davis. $15 registration fee. R706. plates and wheels missing. The flag is missing too. Only the one wheel.
Stealing the wheels is for amateurs. Car ring would have stripped it in a warehouse.
It's around the car, where's that? Cup.
Don't think this is anything. I don't think so.
Oh, that's useless. What's over here? Wrench.
Combination wrench. Must have used it to remove the wheel lugs.
Damned if his clothes weren't covered in gunpowder residue.
That.
Don't think this is any use to us.
Evidence we're missing. Wow. Maybe in the trunk of the car. If there is a trunk. What? Oh, shit.
Seems irrelevant.
Okay, that trunk.
Empty.
Nothing. A call. Apparently, making a call to an address counts as clues that.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, detective?
Could you run the name Dewey Brothers? Possibly a dealership or car mechanics workshop.
Who's here?
One moment. Dewey Brothers Packard Dealership, 629 Figueroa Street.
Got it. Thanks for your help.
Is that all the clues? Not. There's more clues around. At the wrench, we looked at the car. Let me, pause the game. Took away my food in the figure this out. All right, I will be.
Shake.
And I'm back. I meet some Michael Donalds. Squeezies, as I call it. I hate this bag shit, bro. Especially my McDonald's. I'm not. That my honey mustard. On with there it is. Ooh. Aw, you. Did I pick hot mustard by mistake? Could have sworn I picked honey mustard. Oh, I could have sworn I picked hot mustard. No, I picked hot mustard. My mistake. Oh well. Already found the clue on this.
Help me out. Check the car and the surrounds. This is a crime scene. We don't want anything missed.
Around the... It. What? Literally on the other side. What? It's where the car is? What did I miss? I knew it was one of the flags. I need to get to a specific location.
I must have taken the flag as a souvenir. Can't have any street value.
God damn it. Alright, go talk to Jacobs. Jacob!
Oswald Jacobs?
That's right.
What exactly happened here, Mr. Jacobs?
Last night, I was looking out of my window. I like to keep an eye on what's going on.
I can understand that.
You see this empty lot? Damn kids play stickball here. Always breaking my windows. Always asking for their ball back.
Can we get back to the car, Mr. Jacobs?
Don't be impatient, Sonny. Anyways, last night I see this brand spanking new Packard up on bricks.
Okay. What do we got for evidence? Stolen Packard, registration slips, missing license plates, wheel. Wrench. Flag. Alright, what you saw?
Did you see who stole the Packard?
Hell yes, I did. I saw three goddamn Mexicans going to work on it.
Yeah. Three Mexicans.
Can you tell us what they were doing?
Using the headlights of an old Ford so they could strip the thing. I yelled out to them, I'll call the cops. So they loaded up their car and drove off. Tooting and hollering and yelling obscenities at me in Mexican.
You speak Spanish, sir?
No, I do not.
Obviously. Come on. So what about these Mexicans, man?
After the Mexicans left, you didn't go anywhere near the car?
After I scared them off? No, I didn't go anywhere near that car.
I don't know about that. I doubt it.
You went out to the car. Once they were gone, you had to take a look for yourself.
I was curious. Ain't a law against that. So what if I took a look around that car? You can't be accusing me of nothing.
How about the suspect?
Tell me about the car they were driving.
It was an old Ford. I didn't catch the license number.
A truth or a lie? Seems like a truth.
You look like the kind of guy who notices details.
You're right there. The car was old, but it looked brand new. Can't candy apple red paint job stands out a mile.
All right. What about the parts?
What exactly did you see them take?
They was working on the tires. That's all that was took.
No. No. Is it doubt or a lie? Let me see. Because, you know, actually, no, that is a lie.
Why did you take the license plate?
Me? What would I do with license plates? You saying I have them?
No.
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out.
Right. So what did you take, Jacobs? Do you want my partner to pat you down?
I found a notebook in the glove compartment. I was going to show you. It's on the chair on my porch.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Jacobs. You can speak to Officer Thibault about signing a formal statement.
When you get the car out of the way, maybe you could come back and do something about those kids.
No.
How about we bring you an umpire's mask?
Ah! Oh, shit. Look, one of his windows got hit in. You think they'd hit this window? Alright, let me look at this notebook. 1947 agenda. Juan Francisco Valdez. On Madston.
Okay, so we have the owner of the vehicle. A degenerate. I'll run John Madston by R&I.
John Henry Stanley Walter. Hey, what's up, Commander? Listen very closely. All right, I'm listening. Well, keep my eye on the chat, okay? There's an important part coming. And I think I may know... I think I know what part you're talking about. Walter, Ben, Teddy, Jimmy, Sammy, Freddy, Daniel, Miguel, Kristen, Larry, Danny, Frankie, Christian. Two Dannys! Two Danny. Timothy, Jean, Kenneth. Oh.
Contact details on a William Dewey. This looks like business rather than pleasure.
Jean, Kenneth, Jeremy, Jacob. Willie, William. Sorry, weren't able to get some games last night. Took me longer than anticipated to get all set up and train. That's fine. As long as I saw that you were playing, for instance, some Street Fighter 6. You can always get some next time whenever you're available. And also, you should really look into getting some VC channels in your Discord server. You don't have to do voices in OBS if that's what you're using, but just, you know, get some voice in there. More streams in the future. All right, lit. All I need to know. Put the book. Aren't I have something to tell. So I think Grand Blue will be my primary one. That's fine.
Phelps, 1247.
You don't have to play every fighting game, but at the same time,
can
you can always expand.
Please.
Connecting you now.
Remember that you Discord for voice much? Probably wouldn't be a bad idea.
Can I help you?
Yeah.
LAPD, man.
Better to have someone in like in a VC channel kind of talk it with you and explain it best way you can. Also,
how old is your boy?
Getting some voices in.
Just turned 16.
Oh, shit.
Wrong person, Mrs. Madson. Sorry to disturb you.
Touching barely legal teens. No!
There's just one message for you, Detective. A four-door Packard diplomatic license number Paul Robert 706 was reported missing this morning by Juan Francisco Valdez.
That's the car here.
He's already here at Central, Detective. He's demanding an audience, as he calls it.
Can you get a message to Captain Leary? Tell him we'll be in as soon as we can.
Okay. We'll go talk to Valdez, but I can also go to the car dealership.
Can you cordon off this lot until we have the vehicle impounded?
Yes, sir, Detective.
We'll follow up on the owner. Get a statement from Jacobs, and I'll read your report back at the station.
Let's go to the dealership first. Come on, Bukowski, we gotta solve the crimes.
This has gotta be the 50th abandoned vehicle call we have caught this year. One more, and I'm gonna go crazy. Not your favorite cases? You kidding me? This is barely even police work. Of all the bad guys in this city, we get lumped with the ones who can't even be bothered to keep what they steal.
Yeah, Bukowski's been in traffic for too long. I don't blame him. Shit work. Not sure if I have the capacity to play every fighting game out there. Sticking to Striver, Grand Blue, like Street Fighter 6 and Tekken, something occasional. That's fine. Getting into every fighting game known to man is not something you can do in a couple of months. I should know. It took me years to even get a grasp of many different fighting games.
Caught sight of the new model four-door and couldn't help yourself. You could see yourself in that car and just had to take a closer look.
Takes a lot of muscle memory to differentiate all the different ones.
LAPD, Mac. We'd like to speak with the owner.
That's me, William Dewey, proprietor at your service.
We're investigating the theft of a Packard belonging to the Argentine embassy. Are you missing a combination wrench?
I don't know, Detective, but I know how we can find out. Follow me.
Okay. So many fighting games I played. Street Fighter, Tekken,
we keep all our tools in
Blaze
here.
Blue, Guilty Gear, Mortal Kombat.
Mind if we look around?
Ash.
Be my guest.
So many of them.
You sure
took
you
me years to
in a
to
new
just
car? Huh? Maybe a used car. I have some nice used cars for guys of your wage bracket.
Why don't you give us some alone time, Dewey? Go sell some cars or whatever it is that you do.
Seems to be a no, no.
That's not right.
In a three half. Oh,
wrong size. One left.
Gabriel Delgado is missing a three quarter.
Found a three quarter at the scene of the crime. Do you have any intuition? Late to the FGC scene, and the Shrive shortly after it came out, stuck primary to Granblue. I mean, you can never really be late to the FGC scene, because there's always more fighting games being made. You're just part of a different, just got part of a different generation. Playing video games since I was like 3, and been playing fighting games since I was 9 when Street Fighter 4 came out. Been playing for over 10 years. I got a lot of time and skill underneath my belt. There are clues to be found?
What do you think? We'll need a full statement from Dewey to put in our report.
Ain't nothing, man. Yo, Dewey!
If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
Started playing games in kindergarten. Started taking fighting games for the past few years. The fundamentals that veteran FGC players have. Yeah. Because fighting games, especially Striving Granblue, these are kind of like, they're very different in terms of your traditional fighting games like Street Fighter and Tekken, so you'll learn how to play that game, but learning the fundamentals is something that only games like Street Fighter and Tekken could really teach. I mean, no. You could learn fundamentals in Granblue, but It's very different. Like learning a different language.
Packards are great cars, but this doesn't look like the kind of place favored by foreign embassies. How do you know Valdez?
I don't know Valdez. The embassy bought the car. All I know is he must know a quality car when he sees one.
Seems truthful.
So Valdez was just driving by and saw the car.
Yeah, something like that. Happens all the time.
Fucked up.
Where can we find Delgado?
I don't know. He sure as hell isn't here.
Not to fucking doubt.
Address, Dewey, or my partner shoves her head in a car door.
Okay, all right. Apartment 3103 Hill Street. And tell him from me, if he ever shows his face around here again, I'm gonna kick his butt from here to Kingdom Come.
That was a massive lie. There's no way you don't know where your employee lives.
A wrench from this dealership was used to strip the wheels from a Packard last night, Mr. Dewey. A couple of Hispanics were seen taking parts.
We've had a spate of thefts ourselves. Comes with the location. Thieving bastards will steal anything the minute your back is turned.
That should be truth.
So that's it?
He's just a lying sack of shit?
The workshop's too close to the street. It's difficult to keep an eye on it.
Damn it!
We'll be keeping an eye on you, Dewey. And spreading the word that you don't like to cooperate with the LAPD. Time to visit Gabriel Delgado. See how good his excuse is.
Yes, this is a it's a detective game. He was not truthful at all. God damn. You drive.
Can you drive to this one? And where exactly are we going?
Go back to the police station. Back to the police station. Oh, God. Die.
You read this story in the Examiner about the Navy developing three-dimensional movies? What's a dimension? You know, like a graph. Vertical axis is Y and horizontal is X.
Well, that's clear as mud.
Third dimension would be Z. So, things would be popping out of the screen.
That's ridiculous. Scare people out of the theater.
God's name would want that. I don't know. People scoffed at the idea of talkies in color. Look what we have now.
Bukowski. 3D movies are dumb. They'll never take off. Heard it here first, folks.
Do we have a Juan Francisco Valdez in for questioning?
Sure do, Phelps. Your bird's in interview, too. And get this. He's wearing gloves and doing his best not to touch anything. Can you beat that?
Sounds like we don't want to keep this guy waiting. It's this way.
Parker or Green? I don't know who these were.
They weren't even in print and he still.
About time. Are you the senior officer I requested?
Oh, yeah, you know it's coming.
I'm Detective Phelps and this is Detective Bukowski.
Have you any idea how long I've been waiting to speak with you? I am needed back at the consulate, and you keep me here like a common criminal.
All right, friend. Let's take a deep breath and start all over again.
Mr. Valdez.
Counsel General. I insist on my full title.
Right, you gotta do this right.
Where did you purchase the car?
My secretary and driver arranged the purchase. A disreputable place, a Dewey Brothers by name. As soon as I can have it arranged, I will have my Hispano-Suiza brought up from Buenos Aires.
Not being truth. I want to say my intuition. Let's do that. I think it would be doubt.
Bought a Packard, Valdez? A snob like you doesn't drive an American car. I want answers or I'll smack you around the teeth.
William Dewey, offered me a substantial bribe to make a purchase at his establishment. It is not unusual to make this kind of transaction in the civil service.
Okay, so that's what I missed.
To the Argentine taxpayers.
That's what I missed when I talked to Dewey. I honestly didn't know that. Wait a minute. Actually, do I know that? Hold on. Fuck. I missed it. That was a lie. Why didn't I need to pay attention?
Consul General, we have located your car. Can you tell us how it was stolen?
It must have been stolen from the consular garage. Terribly inconvenient, of course.
And
I want the perpetrator soundly flogged.
Unfortunately, we don't do that here, Your Worship.
No.
You have a pretty good idea who stole the car, don't you, Consul General? Are you going to tell me, or do I shake it out of you?
There's no call for violence. I suspect a disgruntled boy from the car dealership.
You have a name for this kid?
Gabriel, like the archangel. I have no surname.
Yeah, it's coming. It's coming.
So tell us about this kid, Gabriel. You had a run-in with him?
Mecánico. A presumptuous young man who did not know his place. He presumed to ask me questions.
We do a lot of presuming here in the United States, Consul General. Comes with the turf.
Make sure you clip it when it presses fucking button. 3, 2, 1.
You fuck young boys, Valdez.
Are you mad? This will cause an international incident.
The best fucking line in the game. Oh, it's so good. Anyway, it's a notebook, you lying sack of shit.
Danny, Ben, Miguel, Tristan, and Teddy. Full lips.
Oh no, look at his hands! They're not folding correctly! Because he has gloves on.
Gabriel, spill it.
A beautiful but impertinent.
Why does his hand. Look at his hands, they're so flat!
I mentioned rendezvous and the young man went quite insane. I thought he was going to kill me. I was prepared to pay.
We'll be in touch.
Oh, I got that one. Damn, I fucked up with Dewey.
Let's
all because he didn't remember
down.
The notebook.
Wrap this thing up.
All right, let's go to his house.
Finished with Valdez.
Thank God. I'll get rid of him in a couple of hours.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes. All right. Where to?
Oh, boys, great.
KTI Radio reminds you.
TI Radio. Now that the moment's passed, I knew about that line, and it is amazing. Fuck young boys, Valdez. The way he said it so casually, too, is like, Hey, man, what's going on with that? Oh. The three Mexicanos!
I just hope our archangel hasn't already flown.
What's going on?
What's going on?
What the hell is this guy doing?
Hey, that's that cop. Seems like a decent guy.
I'm stumped. Ideas?
Let's knock on Gabriel's door, see who's home.
Right.
Here he is, apartment 3.
All right. Oh, that's him.
Yet.
LAPD, ma'am. We're looking for Gabriel Delgado.
Gabriel?
We're from the police. Policia, you understand?
Yes, I understand.
She's speaking in English, dude.
Could you come inside?
What is your name?
Ana Rodriguez.
Is Gabriel Delgado here, Ms. Rodriguez?
No. What do you want with Gabriel? he in trouble?
Stay where you are, Miss Rodriguez. We need to take a look around.
But he is not here. I have told you.
Check out the surrounds. I'll stay with the broad.
What? Oh boy, it's the flag.
So how far along are you, Anna?
Shit.
Doesn't tell me anything.
Nearly 20.
God's holy book next to...
Right. So
next to a souvenir of sin.
And he's not around.
What you doing? What
you
doing, Gabrielle?
He will be a good father.
Souvenirs are a dumb
Already
move.
He works hard to provide for us.
Unless you help us here,
an
Anna,
article of crime next to the God's holy
very
book.
Long time.
What's going on here?
Difficult to tell whether it's the suspect vehicle from the scene.
Not.
And Gabriel's pride and joy.
Definitely not. Like, what? That car looked nothing like the Packard.
This doesn't pertain to the case.
Nombres de bebé. Boy. Boy. Nothing in here.
Serving breakfast for two, Anna? You should have cleared up.
Person here. Golden doorknob. Always look out for golden doorknobs. Uh-oh.
Probably nothing.
What tool is this? All objects are relevant to your investigation. They're just around to fuck with you. Plates! Ah, there's a plate from the car.
Diplomatic license plates.
Dip. Dipper. Surrey tool. The wheels!
It looks like Valdez gets his wheel back.
All the clues. Alright, time to interrogate Anna.
You're in serious trouble, Miss Rodriguez.
But Gabriel is not here. I have done nothing wrong.
Yelling. Alright, what's going on with this GTA? Not GTA.
Why did he steal the car, Anna?
The customer insulted him. He has his honor, no?
Doubt that. Fuck.
Gabriel's been in trouble before. He left you here alone to answer for him, and you expect me to believe that his motive was honor?
Please don't yell at me. I've done nothing wrong.
Yo, you're... Since I started this interview. Yeah, I fucked up.
Tell us the truth, Anna. Has Gabriel been here?
I haven't seen him for at least 3 nights.
That's a lie.
You keep lying to me, and I'll send you and your baby to jail.
He lives here, but he hasn't come home. I swear it.
About that breakfast. Fuck.
Enough, Anna. There are signs all over this place that he's been back.
I need to look at my evidence before I answer a prompt.
I have never seen him so angry. He went out to his shed and put some things in it. I don't know what, and I don't want to know.
Should.
I love him.
We found a license plate matching our stolen vehicle in the shed. Add in the assortment of parts, and we can make Gabriel for a dozen other thefts. It's time to get serious, Anna.
You must ask these questions of Gabriel. I know nothing of these car parts.
On. Shed, man. Maybe a lie. Fuck, that's asking the community is more beneficial than removing an answer. Doubt.
Then tell us where he is. If your baby is born in prison, Anna, the corrections officers will take it from you. You will see your son or daughter through a metal grate for half an hour a week.
The start line is on 1st and Santa Fe. There is a spillway under the bridge that leads to the river. Many policia have wrecked trying to follow him.
I need to check if there's...
We're
all right.
A good word for you, Anna. As far as we're concerned...
For the next case, I need to check to see if there's evidence that proves him wrong. Or answering
like
a prompt. Because they could be lying, but I have to look into the evidence that actually are lying. Because I'm making too many mistakes. I think I've missed, like... Four or five different...
Stop these clowns and get them off the street.
I think I missed like four or five questions because... We're in a dead end.
What kind of man leaves his pregnant girlfriend at home while he goes off to play cars?
Pregnant girlfriends aren't always a barrel of laughs. Everyone needs to let off a little steam. Some guys wouldn't come back home at all.
Are you talking from experience?
A, B. All right. Damn, what was the motive?
There's the red Ford. That's Delgado right there.
Go, 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 go! Also, why are you doing this on an open street?
Quick, they're getting away!
Phelps, 1247, requesting assistance at 1st and Santa Fe. Reports of an illegal street race.
Fuck! Oh, they're trying to stop me!
Quick as we shut one of these races down, another one springs up somewhere else. Kids used to steal cars to sell them. Now they just want to wrap them around a lamppost. The next
road
I have to peel off the sidewalk, your call. I've had enough to last me a lifetime.
I messed up. Can I still see him? He's in the distance. Oh, God!
Delgado is our boy. Forget the others.
They're trying to stop me! Fuck! Left.
Away.
He's not, he's right here.
Step on it, Phelps. Take him out.
Come on, you bastard. Can you, like, shoot your gun, Bukowski? No, you got one. Come on. Getting in the water to fuck with me.
Damn it, Cole, hold it steady.
Shut up. Oh! Hey, stop.
Gabriel Delgado, you're under arrest for Grand Theft Auto.
Fuck you, puto. You just speak to the maricón. Valdez, I showed him. Now who's a man? I should have burned his fucking car!
Maybe. But you didn't, so you go to jail.
You got a foreign dignitary outed as a fruit and a kitty raper, a car dealer we're gonna let slide for the kickback, and a street punk car thief who sure as hell won't be taking liberties with other people's autos again anytime soon. That, Detective Phelps, is not a bad haul. You keep your chin low and your hands high, and you keep bringing me clearances just like that one. That's textbook policing, and we need more of it in this department.
Cassie gets nothing. well, good job. It helped me out. How many did I miss? Only three questions. Yeah, two of them from Dewey, and one from Anna. Argentinian Consul General Juan Valdez gets his Packard back almost in one piece. $145 in city damages. Yeah, I'm not doing too bad, but I'm not really putting that much thought into it. Gotta do that more.
You have any plans for weekend Liberty, Jack?
My sisters have been working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before Liberty.
Uh-oh.
Good job, Kelso.
It Phelps being a toady.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection. It'd better be exceptional if any of you want Liberty this weekend. Kelso. This carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend Liberty canceled. 2-day field drill.
On, Kelso.
Clean this rifle. No. Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished? Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Damn it, Kelso. Fucked up everyone's liberty. All because you couldn't clean a rifle. And yeah, I mean, the other guy said it was a nice job, but... Maybe he did it to fuck with him. But still, just clean the damn rifle. Marriage made in heaven! Made in heaven! No! Damn, hit and run. God damn!
Alright, gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit and run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there. See if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
I say we bust in there and find the goddamn evidence.
I mean, don't you do that already? Cases you've unlocked or downloaded can be accessed via replay in the cases section of the main menu. For, you know, the completionist value and whatnot. In case you want to do it all perfectly, now knowing the answers.
You're behind the wheel.
Oh.
Looks like the DA is going to press charges. Anna Rodriguez might do time.
Aw, shit.
I'll speak to the DA. She suffered enough.
I don't know, Cole. She's an easy make, and the DA likes conviction.
She's pregnant, dumbass.
I'll convince him to let it go.
How do you do that?
I'll give him something better.
Like, what the fuck? Alright. Find all the clues. Look over evidence. Guarantee if they are lying or not. That's the new thing to do. I want to do the case as best as I could. Get that smear. He got dragged, yo. Fuck. Person of interest. Another person of interest. You can tell towards the center of the camera.
Detectives, over here.
Cole Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
I think it's a white male named Lester Patterson. Walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar. Her name is Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old, she left Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so?
We'll take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
Holy shit. Like, in the cutscene, he barely stepped 1 foot off the curb.
Phelps, you should take a look.
Landed on his face and ended up here. Car must have struck him from behind.
It hit him dead on. Face. Check the jacket pocket. How do you know there's something in there? Mr. Patterson, dear Mr. Patterson, is a great It is a great pleasure that we acknowledge the receipt of your application 14F4 and a pre-approval has been granted to raise your weekly premium of life insurance from $370 per week to $590. Wait a minute, not bad. Oh no, that's actually bad. Wait. Hold up. Oh wait, no, hold on. Weekly premium of life insurance from $370 to $590. The raise effective. Oh, is he getting a raise? Okay. For our standard veteran care policy is entitled due to a lump sum of $10,000 in event of your ultimate timely death or permanent caps. God damn it. Permanent incapacitation. That's a weird. This new plan ensures your beneficiaries a sum of $16,000. We had California Fire and Life. Thank you and wish you a good health and security for the future.
Madison has life insurance.
I think that's all the clues I'm going to get off this body. Never mind.
We can notify next of kin.
That was a weird angle. Patterson, 182 North Hope, male, 5'8". Married, yes, he is married. Age 36. Shit. Honey. Alright, enough of the body.
What have you got on the victim?
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident. I'll know how intoxicated once I've done the autopsy. Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest wound? Isn't that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers.
Get the blood! Oh, God! Look at the... Oh, shit!
Body traveled a good 20 feet.
Oh my fucking god! Holy shit! That's a bad way to go.
This blood is a long way from the body. Car must have been going like a bat out of hell.
Like. Oh, wait. Oh, this blood don't match the blood. Tried to brake.
So the driver managed to brake before the impact.
Yep. Before we talk to the Goyle, check around for more stuff. Uh-oh. Knife!
Knife covered in blood. Could be a steak knife. This is a hit-and-run case, Phelps. Anyone could have thrown away a kitchen knife.
In any case, we'll want tech services to scrub the alleyway before they bag the knife.
More clues. Got nothing to do with the damn hat. This fucking hat is nothing. Is it nothing? Dang, there's... Yeah, it's nothing. Okay, there's more clues. Need to know. Let me check the garbage can.
She's all yours, detective.
Talking to her yet. All the clues. Till I find the clues. Kowski, I don't know.
What now?
Witness statements next. We know we've got the girl as an eyeball, but we should check the bar as well.
Okay. I wanted to check all the evidence. Yes, I can. There. Body's there. The knife's over there. Thank God they... Alright, fuck it. Let's just talk to the... no. I want to check all the evidence. Spark plug.
Optimistic, Cole.
Stick, Cole. This ain't shit. What the? No. No. Get away. Shit. Alright, fuck it. Let's talk to the girl.
Miss Perry?
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski.
So what'd you see?
Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
Now, what did the vehicle look like?
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
Very descriptive. What about the argument?
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well, there were two voices. A man and a woman. That's all.
How about that? Oh, yeah, and I don't know about that.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
I'm sorry.
Damn, Phelps, why are you going so hard?
I'd like to get my picture in the paper. Trying to find work as an actress, and things look pretty difficult.
Cough it up, sister. We don't have all night.
People arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
Damn.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
Hey, you got an intuition point.
You certainly got away with the dames, Phelps.
She lived here.
Give it a rest, Bukowski. Let's see what the patrons have to say. I'll take the bartender. You work the rest of the room.
Information paper. Shrink to the stars. Promises mental breakthrough. I was about to say breakdown. Breakdown. Test subject shows dramatic improvement.
Courtney, come in. Have a seat.
Thanks, doctor.
How are you finding working at the clinic?
It's fine.
Are you sure?
Can I be honest with you, doctor?
I would hope so, Courtney.
I was hoping that the therapy would be more beneficial.
What do you mean?
Treatment can, unfortunately, be very long-term.
So many of the patients here are addicts, doctor.
Uh-oh.
Many of them have been for years.
They like the drugs, man. Come on.
These people were condemned to sanatoriums. We can reveal the root of the problem, then we have a chance to help them.
And until then, they stay sedated?
Do I detect a hint of reproach, Courtney?
I was expecting more, doctor. I'm sorry. I don't mean to criticize.
Part of being a physician, Courtney, is learning to be patient.
How is it possible to keep so many of them on their medications, doctor? Many of their addictions are illegal.
Oh, many things in life are gray, Courtney.
Uh-oh.
What may on the surface appear to be illegal is actually of benefit to society at large.
Fontaine's down with the... He's not down with the illegal stuff, but it's... Well, I mean, come on, man.
Careful where you're stepping, Phelps.
No.
I don't come down to the station house and tap dance on your desk.
You should. It's great. It's great. It's gotta be something big, right? I'll call the game well.
Come on, you can tell me.
I helped it. Look at Bukowski run.
I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, detective. Only one possible make on that license. Registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thank you.
Right now, let's go talk to the people at the bar.
Looks like we caught a break on this one.
I'd like to see things from your point of view, but...
No.
...to get my head that far up my ass.
So I guess I didn't find all the evidence here, and I missed it. Alright, let's talk to the bartender.
I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
What's your take on the hit and run?
What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
Come on, dude.
So what was he doing outside? It's against licensing regulations to drink on the sidewalk.
Esther and Lorna were having a fight. The owner made him take it outside. It was pretty ugly.
Your association with the victim.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah. Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
About the argument.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
You know what they were fighting about, Lynch. Stop lying to me.
So now you know what I know? You a mind reader now?
It's nothing personal. I'm just doing my job. You understand that?
I don't think he's being truthful. May have overheard that argument.
Why was Lorna Patterson in such a hurry to leave? What is going on here?
Lorna was pretty upset, so Leroy took her home. Lorna and Leroy are close. They've been talking about opening a new bar.
Leroy?
Leroy Sabo? The owner?
How long have Lorna and Leroy been talking about this new bar?
Who knows? I just served the drinks.
I'm gonna fucking break your nose, dude.
Bartenders hear all sorts of things. Are you going to tell me, or do we have to start playing rough?
When Lester was drinking, he treated Lorna like dirt. He gambled away all their money. Lorna pitched Leroy about the bar. I don't know how interested he is.
Is Leroy doing well?
Hell no. The only thing keeping this place afloat are the poker games.
Thanks for your help, Lynch. I'm going to need you to sign a statement with the patrolman.
Sure, no problem.
Get anything out of the regulars? They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the Love Tap.
What do we do now?
Advice? We've got to track down that Lincoln, Phelps. We find the car. Then we nail the driver.
Alright. Find the Lincoln. I feel like I could have found more evidence. I hear the music go off. It's, no, this is the coroner's car.
You can drive. Do we know where we're going?
Go to Shelton. The Continental. Could have found more clues. No, I could have. Running.
That's the son of a bitch right there. William Shelton?
Yes?
It doesn't look good, Shelton. You packing your bags and making a run for it? You know why we're here.
Yes. The accident.
We've got witnesses who can put this car at the scene, not to mention the physical damage. This is open and shut, Shelton.
Damn!
That coward thinks he can run from everything.
Ooh! That was my fault. Damn! Fucker loves
enough
his handbrake.
Games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
Whoa! Let's hit that guy. Stop it. Stop it! Let it out!
No wonder he killed someone driving like this.
Fucker. He's still up? Not getting away with this.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
Trying, man. Fuck.
Don't let that asshole get away.
Someone got hurt. Oh god. Ugh. See you over there. Going into the park? Damn you, you crazy bastard. Oh! Almost hit someone. Oh shit. Stopped.
Right, I give up. Oh, Jesus. Put your hands in the air. How does a vehicular manslaughter
Bro wants all that damn it. I need it.
I admit it. I just panicked, but it wasn't my fault.
What do you mean?
The guy jumped right out in front of me. He came out of nowhere. There's nothing I could do about it.
Yeah, all I did was bump into his wheels.
I've had accidents before.
That's it. We're done here. The DA is gonna love you.
They weren't all my fault. I'm a surveyor. I need my license for my job. There were people around. A woman and a man were standing right next to him. I thought they could get him to a hospital. I'm telling you, it's not my fault.
The guy is dead, Shelton.
You can't be serious.
Yes.
William Shelton, you're coming downtown. We need to talk about a manslaughter charge.
Oh, God.
Leave the coroner and the paperwork. Procedure can wait. You should probably go speak to the wife and let her know what's happening.
Go to Ray's Cafe.
You become all here. Prospect of paperwork, don't you?
Wait, we can come back here? Why? So I did miss evidence. Let's go here first and then go back to Ray's Cafe. Oh my god, oh my god, oh, Bukowski, you go, oh no, Bukowski, Bukowski's trying.
You're right, that's pretty unusual behavior. She could be in shock.
Whoa.
Strange things, war, maybe, maybe she doesn't give a fuck. According to the patrons, her old man was a piece of work.
You don't think, Phelps, the guy was run over. So it worked out well for this broad. So what? Maybe she deserved to catch a break. Who knows?
It's fucked up. Also, I think some of these music cues on the radio might be DMCA'd for my stream, because these sound like real tracks from the 40s. The hell do I know about 40? Hey.
Yes? Hello?
Mrs. Patterson.
Is this about my husband?
We're investigating the incident, ma'am.
I see. Come in, won't you?
Can you tell me what happened?
What's to tell? He got hit by a car and now he's dead.
Damn.
You don't appear to be too upset about the fact.
Lester and I met on a furlough in 44. We got married that weekend. People don't understand it now, but that happened a lot back then.
I see.
It's 47.
So you probably did well to stick it out this long.
What's that supposed to mean, mister? I think it's about time you left. I have someone here.
I beg your pardon? You're gonna have to run that one by us again, sister.
It's okay, Lorna. I'm Leroy Sabo.
Well, well. Nice to see you're comforting the grieving widow, Mr. Sabo.
All right, wise guy. Do you have any intelligent questions you would like me to answer?
You can confirm Mrs. Patterson's story.
Lester lost at cards. He was kind of hard to control when he lost his temper. Turned without looking and walked right out in front of the car. It wasn't good.
What's your relationship with Mrs. Patterson, Mr. Sabo?
We're friends. Good friends.
Good friends.
Look, I was filing for divorce. Mental cruelty. Lester could be a mean son of a bitch.
Mental cruelty?
And Lester knew about that?
Is that a thing?
I hadn't told him.
Well, hasn't this worked out well for the two of you? I feel almost bad for busting in on this little rendezvous.
Alright, what's your take on the incident?
How did the car come to hit Lester?
He walked straight into the path of an oncoming car.
God. Alright, let me look at my notebook. Alright. Continental. Insurance letter. Found on his corpse. Wallet. Said it was intoxicated, possibly caused by a vehicle hood ornament, stainless knife. A liar doubt.
You're lying, Lorna. You pushed him in front of the car.
If you think you can prove that, I suggest you arrest me now.
Oh, can't prove that.
Don't ask, you never find out.
I want, there's a specific line I want, and I need it. This could be a doubt, but I'm thinking the knife might have something to do with it. I did say I wanted to save my intuition. Fuck it. It's doubt. I'm overthinking again.
You expect me to believe that?
Oh! Luka Bukowski doesn't like that.
Gambling for Lester was like the needle for a hophead. He was yelling at me. He was yelling at the whole world. I kind of felt sorry for the driver. Poor guy had no chance.
Damn. So what was the argument about?
You were arguing in the bar and on the sidewalk.
We were always arguing. So what?
On Rod.
Admit it. You were baiting him, pushing his buttons. We can easily get the full story from the regulars in the bar.
All right. Lester was playing cards out back. He lost, of course, and wanted back in. He suggested I earn the money on my back to get a mistake. That was the proposition he was putting to his so-called buddies. So maybe I was a little angrier than usual. Let's just say I took exception to his idea.
So what's your deal about Sabo?
The bartender said that you and Leroy were planning to go into business together. Can you explain how you'll get the money to do that?
I have a little money saved away.
Now that's a fucking lie, and I have the proof for it.
You're being economical with the truth, Lorna.
You want to back that up, little man?
About the insurance letter.
You increased the premium on Lester's life insurance. GI insurance policies have a $10,000 payout.
It was Leroy's idea. Lester lived on the edge. He was always...
That's why it was what the fuck. Crack game. Because he didn't authorize it himself. He had an extra $6,000.
Speaks to motive and premeditation, Lorna.
You're forgetting the hit-and-run detective.
You and Mr. Sabo have an interesting day.
I'm sure we will, officer. Now, if you could both just leave.
We're leaving, ma'am. Sorry for your loss. I can see what a tough time you're having with all this.
I never thought that first question. Thought the knife may have had something to do with it, but I guess not. What the hell was the knife even doing there? Go check the phone. Check the phone for some messages. Pick up the phone.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Messages for me, please.
Just one, Detective, from the coroner. Message reads, Phelps, see me at Central Morgue immediately. Results of the Patterson autopsy.
Thanks, ma'am.
Get out of the morgue. You know, let's go back to the cafe, because apparently that's not X'd out on my thing. I may have missed one piece of evidence. Move over.
I need to go over the case notes. So, where you want to go?
Go back to the bar. Might be something we missed. Maybe further in, back at the poker, the poker tables. That might have been what I missed. Seemed like the street itself had enough clues laid out. Is a back. I could go through the back. What? Talking about dings on the phone? Oh, wait, is that a gold door? Oh, it is! Looked like one.
This is why everybody comes to Ray's.
That's all I have? Here. Where to find, or was I too late? I should have used my intuition to find all the clues here. Fuck. Oh well.
Sorry, pal, that's all I got. Even bartenders run out of gossip.
Shit. Oh, let's get to the morgue.
Can you drive to this one?
Fine. Where are we headed?
Sounds muffled.
That's the cop from the newspaper.
Back to the morgue. Not for sure. Something. I don't know.
We could put the driver in front of a judge in less than a week. You'd be making a big mistake.
Run that by me again?
The victim was dead before the car hit him. Two puncture wounds to the right side of the thorax.
A knife!
The puncture reached his heart. You're kidding me. Been doing this job 23 years, son. No one's ever laughed at one of my jokes.
He was stabbed to death?
Long, sharp knife.
length of a bayonet.
We found a knife in the alleyway.
Where is it now? Was it bagged?
By Patrolman Kaplan.
Perfect. I'll get you a definite match.
Jesus, we got him.
Oh, that's why Ray Cafe was,
Get the gas chamber.
We have the knife, we have the corners.
Hold up.
And I bet we could roll
some. Yeah, find the blood-saved knife. Yeah, see? That's why we were able to find the knife. They want you to go back to the crime scene to find the knife in case you forget it. That makes sense.
You can drive. Spoken to the coroner, Mrs. Patterson. He confirmed your husband's cause of death. We'd like you to come downtown and answer some questions.
It wasn't me. It was Leroy's idea.
Uh-oh.
Leroy stabbed him. I had nothing to do with it.
Where is Leroy now?
He's in the bedroom.
You're very good, Lorna.
Put the gun down, Leroy. If you do something stupid now, you don't stand a chance in front of the grand jury.
Nice of you to give me up, sweetheart. All that whispering in my ear, telling me how we had to get rid of him, how good it could be, all the money we could claim, all that planning, how to get him into the street, how to make...
Get out of the way, dumbass.
You had all the bases covered, baby.
I have nothing to do
with it. You think I'm gonna fry for you, Lorna?
He's a crazy man. Shoot him. Shoot him for God's sake.
Smooth, bitch. God damn. Now you're probably fucking dead. Whoa! Dumb fuck. Damn it. Gotta cross the street. Fuck! That was gonna run further down.
Stop or I will shoot.
Damn it! A clear shot on him. Could have sworn I shot him in the head, too. Come on, you fuck. What you running for? What you running for? Uh-oh. Got a hostage!
You come any closer and I will pull the trigger.
Put the weapon down now.
Got him.
Help me!
She's stuck! She's stuck! Oof.
You look spooked, Phelps. I thought you'd been under fire before. Never gets any easier, Bukowski.
What? I shot him in the head. Well, we did it. We killed the bad man. Lorna's probably dead. Probably dead as hell.
So, I give you a hit and run. You bring me back fraud, conspiracy, and first degree murder. This is how a good detective operates, Phelps. You take nothing at face value. You keep digging and asking questions until you get to the truth. You got some sharp elbows on you, detective. I like that. Keep up the good work.
Woo! Correctly branch every question and interview in a successful story. Fucking crushed it! Crushed that case! Another visit to Ray's, and you would have seen what Leroy was prepared to avoid to do to avoid jail. Oh. But Leroy was prepared to... That's what I was doing. Wait. Could have seen what Leroy was prepared to do to avoid jail. Hmm? Really? Even though I did it perfectly, I missed something. A slip of the tongue! Alright, well, I'll try to be more observant. Alright, this is gonna be the last case, and I'll turn it off.
Phelps, Bukowski.
B-Cop says he located a green Kaiser Frazier from the hot sheet. Address is 6 West 2nd Street. Get over there and see what you can find out. Go on. Sorry to inconvenience you.
We're on it, Captain. I swear, the more bent cars we bring in, the longer the hot sheet gets.
It pays the rent, though. Keeps Mrs. Phelps in the manner to which she's accustomed.
I'm not sure she'd agree with you.
Passionate, romantic type like you, Cole?
I don't believe you.
No. It was forcing me into the It was forcing me into the room. Alright.
You know the way. You can drive.
Drive the car.
They're calling her the Dahlia now. Wonder what Veronica Lake makes of that one.
What a case. You hear whether they're making any progress?
Captain Donnelly seems to think they have it all wrapped up. Brown and Green are sweating this Manly character. I heard it'll be in front of a grand jury by next week.
Holy shit!
Poor thing.
Gosky, what the fuck?
Enough being murdered like that without having your death strewn all over the front pages.
I believe this is a DLC mission. They're talking about the Dahlia, which is the Black Dahlia. You're not supposed to know that until the next desk.
That's the car, Cole. Just pulling out of the drive. Get him!
Come on, we were just in the fucking car! Fuck!
Remember, we need him healthy enough to answer questions.
1247, Detective Phelps, requesting immediate backup. In pursuit of a stolen green Kaiser Frazier from 6 West 2nd Street.
Don't know if it was stolen or not. Wait, do we actually? Oh, yeah, it is stolen. I'm dumb. Oh, I'm fucked.
Lay into his wheel arches.
I'm literally trying that. Come on. Oh, I was afraid he was going to swerve. One more hit should do it.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
How about you shoot your gun? Fuck.
All right. Maybe I was a couple miles over the speed limit.
Show me your hands.
Couple miles, huh?
Why did you run from us?
I saw a big car in my rearview mirror with two tough guys bearing down on me. What would you do?
We're literally police.
Under arrest.
For what? What are you talking about?
Nice try. I'm talking about the car being stolen.
You're out of your mind. I bought the car, and I've got the paperwork to prove it.
I also ran from the police. Person. M's West.
We'll have some
West Street.
For the people at Coombs Automotive.
Kaiser Frazier, Manhattan. 2400. A $50 radio and a $1 lighter installment. 2450.95. Shit, if only cars cost that much nowadays, fuck. Alright. Report a stolen, dude. What's up with that?
You purchased this car from Coombs Automotive Company.
Yeah, that's right.
That's true.
And the ownership papers?
From the same place.
I have it all. Cliff Harrison.
This is forgery. It's top notch. This will need to be traced.
Private Frazier Manhattan sedan. Seems to be checked out. You're right. All right. Why'd you run?
You have a criminal record?
No, nothing like that.
Yeah, no, fuck that.
You better give us something.
No.
Make this hard on you.
I didn't steal the car. I ran because I've got some wacky backy in the glove compartment.
Wacky backy.
One reefer.
We'll let it slide. You're in enough trouble.
Wacky backy, he says. So, what's up with the purchase details?
Who did you deal with at Coombs Automotive?
The owner, Richard Coombs.
One of the cars teleported.
And he made out the bill of sale personally?
Of course he did. He kept a facsimile for his records. Check with him.
We're going to get to the bottom of this, Harrison. Until we do, you're going downtown.
You gotta be kidding me! I'm getting arrested for buying a goddamn car?
If everything is legit, Harrison, you'll be out soon. Until then, if I were you, I'd keep my mouth shut. Vegas possessions is evidence. Have him arraigned for grand.
Thought you said we were gonna let it slide. What the fuck?
You know who my father is!
We need to get Don't to care. Auto and check out Harrison's story.
Catch it. I got an achievement for catching him before he stopped by a uniformed backup. I caught him first.
You're behind the wheel.
Oh, fuck! Yo, somebody clipped that! Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Oh, my God! I was just checking my notebook, and then the car just killed me. I didn't even do anything. I'm just looking at my notebook for the next destination. Oh shit, that was so sudden. Oh, that was awesome. Oh fuck, somebody clip that, please. Oh, Layton, thank you for the follow. Oh my god, that was amazing. Now that's a clip if I ever saw one. Holy shit. Oh my god. Yeah, let's go to Coombs.
You can drive. Where are we going?
Holy fuck, that car came out of nowhere. It must have been one of those. Now they stop and go around me. Fuck. Holy shit. Or it must have been this gray one right here.
I think he's telling the truth.
Oh my god.
Some of the most convincing people you will ever listen to are born liars. Usually they're called politicians.
What? Oh man, I've never seen... Oh god, it's been a while since I've seen some dumb shit like that happen. That was my first death of the game. I didn't die by any other means. I died from fucking... From an NPC hitting me in their car. Oh shit, that was awesome. Ooh, alright.
Not another step. I have got a Buick Century sedan that would be absolutely perfect for you.
Detective Phelps, LAPD, are you the owner?
That's right. Richard Coombs at your service. You looking to trade in a black and white, boys?
Mr. Coombs, we're investigating an auto theft. A man by the name of Cliff Harrison claims he bought the car here.
Well, some people would say that my cars are a steal. That's a joke, sir.
Very amusing, Mr. Coombs.
I remember Harrison. It was a green two-tone Kaiser Fraser, if I remember rightly.
You have the bill of sale?
It's in my office. Walk this way.
Oh, my God.
That's a joke too, son.
Phelps, you mind if I shoot this guy? He's getting on my nerves.
That's strike two, man. If it goes to strike three, I'll let you shoot him.
This got the original pink slip there too.
Look at the pink slip first. Gene Archer.
Gene Archer. 146 North Fremont Avenue.
By Coombs, it's got a stamp on it. So then why did we get one from him? Is it the same car? So this is Cliff Harrison. Signed by Cliff Harrison. Yep.
Harrison's purchase receipt was legit, at least.
Was. Why was the pink slip under a different name? That's weird.
We have a couple of questions.
All right, fellas. Shoot.
All right. What happened with the transaction? Let me move over my evidence first. Vehicle was stolen. Got a receipt. Both Harrison and Archer and Archer's pink sheets. Both sale. All right. How'd the transaction go?
Can you tell us how you came to buy the car?
Girl just wandered in right off the street.
Okay.
Nothing unusual about the car.
Not really my usual type of vehicle. The price was certainly right, though. Nice girl, but about as sharp as a bag of wet mice.
Did you pay with check or cash?
A check. She wanted it made out to cash.
Oh, the car was originally Jean's, and then he pawned it off. He sold it to,
I made it out to Jean Archer on to the Cliff. Bank of Arcadia.
Whew! Alright. And what the suspect looked like.
Can you describe this Jean Archer?
Brunette, maybe 25, 26. A little on the plump side, but not bone ugly.
Okay.
What was your impression of her?
Kind of harried and harassed. In a hurry to go somewhere, but no place to go. You get to know the type.
Okay. What's the association with the Marquis?
Do you know anything about the company that prints these pink slips?
Nope. Should I? It isn't exactly my business.
Really? Doesn't it have your stamp on it? Seems like he's lying. I'll chance it.
It says Marquis Printing. You've never heard of them?
Marquis. Sure. They do all the government red tape. You'll find the place down on Aliso Street near San Pedro.
All right, then. What about the payment details?
When exactly did you hand over the check, Mr. Holmes?
Close of play on Friday.
Now he's not too sure.
Why didn't you pay her cash? You knew the car was dirty.
I had an inkling. When people are in a hurry for money, always pay by check, son. Gives you a couple days to back out.
Sense. All right, what about the transaction?
This was all above board.
Yes, of course it was.
How about that one, Chief?
Did this look legitimate to you, Coombs?
I'm in used cars, son, not bearer bonds. In my business, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Now don't come on all high and mighty with me if you want my help.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Coombs.
Got it.
We need to continue the investigation.
Hope you sort out your problem with Mr. Harrison. Go easy on him, son. Boy's about as sharp as a bowling ball. He's built too low. The fastballs fly over his head.
All right, that's too many sayings.
Let me shoot this guy, please.
Fortunately, we gotta go. Sorry. Sorry, Bogowski. All right.
Well, Harrison might be off the hook, but we can still run an APB on Gene Archer. Get on the horn and call it in.
Get on the horn. Where's this Jean Archer chick?
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
Can I help, Detective?
Requesting an APB on Jean Archer, age approximately 25, on suspicion of Grand Theft Auto.
I'll relay the information.
Any messages?
A James Belasco is being held at Central Station on suspicion of GTA. Possible link to the Harrison case. They're waiting on you to conduct the interview.
Thanks for your help.
Don't know much of an APB on Gene yet,
can
so...
Can you go into this one?
Actually,
So, where do you want to go?
Yeah, let's go find out where the pink slips are.
Here's a chicken and egg question for you. Do you think you have to be an asshole to sell cars? Or that selling cars turns you into an asshole?
You've got it in
That's
for
a good question.
Today, haven't you?
I've always got it in for car sales. Doesn't matter what day it is. And why do they always think they're comedians when they're about as funny as a heart attack?
Maybe the more annoying they are, the quicker you sign on the dotted line just to get the hell out of there.
That's an interesting conversation. From notebook to bam. Death. I thought I'd survive too. I'd be able to get out. Put a grate on me in an instant. What?
Empty. Should have known that Archer Broad would have given us a false address.
Fuck it.
We should go to the station. See what this black.
You know the way. You
can drive. Not again, not again, not again, not again, not again.
Do we know where we're going?
Don't do it again. Don't do it again. Don't do it again. Don't do it again. Alright, we're good. We're good. We're good. Oh god. I wasn't ready for another one. I was not ready for another one. Oh. Now I'm having PTSD. Oh god. Oh man.
Detectives, Velasco is prepped and ready in two. Another stolen car with legit papers.
Thanks.
Two, right? That's the secretary's room. Interview room. That's one. Not here. Two is here.
Crummy bastard.
The fuck? I just walked in.
James Belasco?
I want a lawyer. It's my car and I got the proof right here. Take a look for yourself.
Okay.
The paper is real enough, Belasco, but the car isn't yours. This pink slip is a forgery.
Is it? What's up, man?
Where were you taking the car, James?
Blow it off, greenhorn. You'll get nothing from me.
I'm gonna fuck you up.
You're a two-time loser. If you don't give me something, I'm gonna ask the DA for the maximum. You're looking at 10 years, Belasco. Kiss your youth goodbye.
I want a deal.
Keep talking and we'll see what sort of deal you're worth.
My job is to drive the cars out of state. Nevada, Arizona, sometimes New Mexico. With the paperwork they provide, it's normally a breeze.
Does the name Jean Archer mean anything to you?
Nope. Never heard of her.
I'd be doubtful. You know, check the notebook. Well. Wait. Wait, yeah, no, you're a fucking liar. This is the same spot.
You're a liar, James.
Say that again. I'm telling the truth. I don't know the broad.
Archer's papers are for the same spot.
I made a mistake.
Is it a lie? Check my intuition. Maybe a lie. Fuck, it's split down the middle. But it's more favorable for doubt. We'll try doubt. It is a lie. Fuck!
My partner here to convince you that you do know her.
Damn it!
I'm giving you the straight dope. I don't know no Jean Archer.
God damn it! Should have went with my gut and fucking... Damn it!
What happens to the cars once they cross over the state lines?
I don't know. I just deliver them.
Fucking lie.
Give me something, Belasco, or I'll take you back to the cells and tell the whole station you're a child molester.
Why didn't you do that with Valdez?
Okay, okay. I hear you. The cars get sold in Chicago or back east. Sometimes I bring back cars coming the other way.
Where do you pick up the cars, Belasco?
Warehouses. Mainly in East downtown.
an address, Velasco. You want my help with the DA? Cough it up, now.
A place on Industrial Street. I don't know the number. You're gonna help me out, right?
Keep talking, kid. We'll see what we can do.
Fuck. It was either the bogus address or his pink slip.
This information is worth anything.
And if it is?
Damn.
I need your help here, pal.
If it is, then we'll know you're a man of your word. And so will the DA.
Sunset Strip. I got a lot of outfits.
You're Phelps, right?
Yes, I am. Look, can we do this later? I'm in the middle of it.
Ray Pinker. I'm with Technical Services. The pink slips are all real.
Yes, we know that.
There's only one company that prints them in California. The Marquee Printing Company. They've confirmed that the numbers are legitimate.
You've checked them out?
Sure. They're on Aliso Street near the corner of San Pedro. The guy I spoke to was Lightfall. Gordon Lightfall. Here. I wrote it down.
Thanks, Ray.
Gordon Lightball, proprietor, Marquee Printing Company. Damn. I should have followed my gut on that lie. It was either the address or the pink slip.
Suspect Gene Archer, spotted by a patrolman. Western Union Office, 253 South Hill. Less than a minute away down the street if you run. Go! She won't hang around.
I gotta get in there myself. Come on! Get in the car! Fucking goddamn it.
Oh, unbelievable.
Not my fault, man.
Come on, we don't want to lose her.
Boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom. It'll only take a little while longer. Hey, you
LAPD.
Bitch.
We'll take it from here.
God damn it. Everyone's against me. Look. Just let me get my money and get out of here, okay?
Those pants are shit.
You look sweet. How about giving a girl a break? I could be very nice.
What's wrong with your arms?
You can't do that, Miss Archer. Stefan, call for black and white.
Just my luck to get the only hair sure cop in the LAPD.
Why'd you steal the car?
The car you sold to Coombs was stolen, Miss Archer. There won't be any money.
I handed over all the right paperwork when I sold it, Buster.
Gene, you've blown open the whole operation because you were dumb enough to try to sell one of the cars. What do you think they're going to do to you? Give me something.
I was just doing what they do. They pay me $50 to drive the car. I made $2,000 selling it.
You made zero. And if they catch you, you're dead. Is that all your life's worth?
Look, a girl needs things. I don't see you looking out for me.
How long have you and Belasco been delivering cars?
Who is James Belasco?
Okay, come on now.
You're lying. James Belasco. I don't remember mentioning his first name, Miss Archer.
Oh, I... Well, I think you did, didn't you? Well, I'm sure of it. Anyway, I don't know him.
Now, what would be the evidence to do this? Would it be his ownership papers or the pink slips themselves? Or would it be the fake address? I think it's the pink slips themselves. I'll try it.
So because you just don't like me, you call me a liar.
You decided to make this hard on yourself, Gene. Let's see how you handle the hard time.
God damn it. Fucked up. I mean, she's behind bars, but I messed up.
You're behind the wheel. And where exactly are we going?
Go to this industrial street. Oh, never mind.
I survived
girl.
Used to getting her own way.
Little did she know her feminine charms were useless against the impenetrable Cole Phelps.
She's not my type.
And what is your type, Phelps?
I'm married.
I know that. But you're not blind or dead inside, are you? Wait, scrap that second half of the question.
I don't know. Blondes, I guess.
Hallelujah! The man is human after all. Now we're getting some. Yep, I'm with you on the blondes. Brunettes are fine, too. And there's nothing wrong with a good redhead. But I draw the line at gray. You know what? I might have to lift that embargo soon in the interest of maintaining a food bar.
A man with high standards.
The standards are only as high as the last glass of whiskey.
Or 10 p.m.
And what can I do for you, gentlemen?
I'm a traffic detective from Central Division. Who's in charge here?
I am, Gordon Lightfall. What's this about?
We understand that your company prints California vehicle titles.
Yes, I have the government contract to print pink slips. I've done for some years.
Have you had any goods or equipment stolen recently? We're running up against stolen cars with seemingly legitimate paperwork.
Not recently. Have you ruled out forgery? There's no shortage of talented artists in this town.
We'll keep it in mind. We have some questions for you, Mr. Lightfall. Mr. Lightfall, we're currently working two auto theft cases. Do you know anything about a car theft ring?
Certainly not. Why would I get mixed up in a thing like that?
I'm being truthful. But I don't know if he's lying or not.
We have suspects with legitimate pink slips that were printed here, Lightfall. You better give me something before I bring the whole department down here.
Don't be hysterical, detective. As a matter of fact, we had a similar problem a couple of years ago. A number of used car lots were selling blank documents to a criminal organization.
Do the names Cliff Harrison and James Belasco mean anything to you?
No, they do not.
Uh-oh.
You sure about that, Mr. Lightfall? You sure you've never heard of them?
Are you making an accusation, young man? Do you have any kind of proof?
Now would be the pink slips, right? That would be the pink slips.
My word is my bond. Character is in short supply these days.
God damn it.
You could do with gaining a little.
Oh, the eyes were pretty big.
Do you have a delivery ledger, Mr. Lightfall? We would like to cross-check against the Coombs Automotive Emporium.
It's a little out of the ordinary, Detective. I'm not sure I can share those sorts of records.
You can and you will.
Hand it over, Lightball. You don't want us having bad thoughts about you, do you?
Very well. But this really is irregular. Over here.
It was a doubt.
Look for patterns, recurring names, unusual addresses, anything out of the ordinary.
Industrial Street.
Certainly encourage repeat business, Lightball. This Mr. Bigelow is a good customer. Sorry to bother you, sir. We'll let you know if there are any developments.
It's a hard case.
You can drive.
Fine. Where are we headed?
You Marines were gung-ho, Cole.
You have a 45. Don't you ever want to use it?
I'll take the back. Just give me a few seconds to get around there.
Time for a shootout. Wow, what a jump over that box.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. All of you are coming downtown with me.
Back in the dome. Oh shit!
I heard something.
All right, don't shoot! Keep your hands up. Watch him, Bukowski. He doesn't move until I've tossed this place.
Ink slips.
There are enough slips here to keep them stealing cars till Christmas.
Looks like Mr. Lightfall has been on a losing streak.
Oh boy. Okay. Should have came here first.
Marquee Printing Company. There's nothing like going direct to the source.
Got him.
We've got a trail of pink slips and stolen cars that leads right to your door, Bigelow. You're in this up to your neck, but I don't think you're the man in charge. Make it easier on yourself. Give him up.
I had to work on cars for customers. You charge in here shooting up the place like it's the Ballad of Bulge. I can't give you anything.
I'm too food.
We know about Marquee Printing. You can make this easier on yourself by giving us your man on the inside.
I sometimes repair cars and put them back on the road. I need a pink slip to resell them. There's no problem there.
That permanent Joker smile, dude. How about that, bro?
There are at least four dead men in this warehouse. A couple more.
Four?
Punks won't make for that much extra.
I counted like you'd be doing eight, system nine.
Okay, tough guy. I get the message. Lightfall. The guy who runs Marquee. He's the big shot. He likes to spend big at the track. He owes people.
Lightfall. The guy with no luck at the track. Tell me about him.
It's one of the guys lying over there.
I'm gonna have other right. Hands.
He has no luck.
Adam.
So if I go over there and check his jacket, your story's gonna ring true? I'm warning you, Bigelow.
God damn it!
Give it a try, Flatfoot. For some reason, none of my guys like to bring ID to work.
Man.
Whether you give up your bosses or not, Bigelow.
We have. Oh, God, I fucked up.
I can put you there.
We'll see. I didn't fire a shot, copper. I just watched you tear my place up.
God damn it. Well, I fucked this case up. Shit. Like, I knew Lightfall was behind it, but I couldn't tie it because I thought it was a doubt. Like, God damn it. Oh well. Don't tell me Gordon's gone. If he's gone, I'd be pissed.
I swear, this town is going straight to hell.
Can you drive to this one?
All right. Where to?
He's gone. I'm gonna be really not happy.
What a mess.
Gonna take some cleaning up, that's for sure.
I wish it hadn't gone that way.
Well, we shouldn't bring guns to work with them. We didn't have a lot of choice.
You have to admire the barefaced cheek of someone who tries to blow your brains out one minute and pleads innocence the next.
Yeah, especially when he's surrounded by evidence. You know, guys like Bigelow spend so much time convincing themselves that they're not doing anything wrong that they actually start to believe their own bullshit.
They get sloppy. Bigelow, Lightfall, all of them. If they hadn't, who knows how long they could have kept this racket going.
Complacency or greed. It's always one of the two that brings them down.
Damn. Want to try this case again, but off stream. I can do it. Or maybe I just, because it's a DLC mission, so it doesn't really matter in the long term. On, I swear to God. No, he's there. All right, lit.
You're under arrest.
You again? This harassment is starting to wear thin.
Why are we questioning him?
We found a box of pink slips in a warehouse full of hot cars. You signed for them, Lightfall.
I signed for all the orders and deliveries. You'll need something better than that, cowboy.
Now I know he's lying.
Save it, Lightfall. We already have all we need to send you down.
I've had enough of this. You either produce some shred of proof, or I call my attorney.
Delivery note.
What you're doing here, slanderous detective. You'll be hearing from my lawyer about it.
It was signed by him!
I'm charging you with conspiracy and fraud. Hands behind your back.
That's crazy! The delivery note was made by him!
Now where shall I start? With the two GTA suspects we had to let walk free? Or with a female suspect who, I am reliably told, slipped the leash with embarrassing ease? You just lost the chance to crack one of the biggest criminal operations in this city. How do you think that makes me look? The chief has my balls in a frying pan! Now get out there and fill some charge sheets. Misdemeanors if you have to. Get me something before I even think about giving you another case.
Damn. Fucked up. Oh, God. Sorry. Sorry, guys. That case was much harder than the last one. Complete slip of the tongue. A majority of the clues and majority of the questions correct. Bigelow might have been a hood, but he had the dirt on Lightfall and would have flipped if encouraged. I mean encouraged. Alright, well, that's it for me. Okay. pretty good stream. Nailed some cases. Messed up this one. Got two really good clips out of it. Oh my god, those clips are gonna be amazing. I might edit those myself personally. Especially the second one. Okay, like what you've watched, hit that follow button and go down further down for the socials down the dashboard. Or click this link right here in the chat, sorry. Burpee. Assy. Tomorrow, instead of playing as cops, we play as lawyers and try out Ace Attorney, Phoenix Wright, the Ace Attorney Trilogy. I'll see you guys tomorrow at 5 p.m. for that stream. Also,